Okay, guys, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Welcome you and SSGMC Shegao. I'm Mangesh Ingade. Welcome you all in the lecture of computer programming. Guys, in today's lecture, it is very important concept. Not only like a programming point of view. Not only C programming point of view, for every programming language, it is very important. Am I clear? Audio is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. Just concentrate, guys, very well, and then we will understand each and every concept in very deep manner. Okay, just focus and concentrate on each and every point, because the agenda of today's lecture to understand the concept of functions. Okay, as we have seen, like from the lecture one, the function, that terminology we continuously using. So right now, this is the time to understand the whole concept of function. So once you understand the whole concept of functions, it means that near about 40% C programming language you understand. 40% plus, I think. So this is very important. If you skip variable and the function concept, then in your whole life, you cannot understand programming concept or any programming language you cannot understand if you skip the concept of variables and the functions. Okay. So in this lecture, we are going to start to understand the concept of functions and their each and every thread.
Sorry, your voice is lagging, sir.
Your voice is lagging me now. Be in a proper network. Am I audible, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So, in this lecture, we will see the functions. Just everyone, please concentrate, and we will discuss it. Okay. Hold on. So, as you can see on your screen, my first question is, what is the function? Right? What is the function? In the previous lecture, we have seen like function is the block. Function is a set of instruction. Function is a one kind of a block. Those statement comes under the open and close curly brace. We called it as a functions, and so many types of like visibility we have seen in the last lectures. Okay, so here you can see on your screen, what is the function? Function in a computer programming, as you can see on your screen, you can see there is a syntax. Directly we will start with the implementation of the syntax. You can see here identity. Identity is my function, okay? And inside that function, you can see there is one open curly brace and the close curly brace, okay? And then open curly brace and the close curly brace, in between that, there will be some kind of logic. Some kind of logic means some kind of programming or some kind of instruction will be there, okay? That instruction, we called it as a generally in a technical term, we called it as a processing logic, as you can see on your screen, okay? So identity is nothing but my function, and that function we called it as a function name. Okay, we called it as function name, as you can see on your screen. Identity is my function, and we called it as a function name. You can see on your screen means identity. Like for example, just below you can concentrate on example, the syntax and example. Here addition is my function, means identity is nothing but the function name. Why I'm calling it as identity? Because by using that identity, you can identify that function or their functionality. Okay. In simple terms, function is nothing but something operation that can be happened in that function or something operation that can be performed by that particular type of entity. Okay. Concentrate. You can see identity is nothing but the name of functions. And with the help of example, you can easily identify. I wanted to perform the addition of two numbers. For that reason, I use one function. That function name is add. So you can use any name. It is completely user defined. Okay. So the syntax, concentrate on the syntax of a function. You can see identity is my function name, right? Okay. All right. Just focus here, guys. It is very important. Just concentrate. You can see here arguments list. Arguments list is what, just be patient, and within 5 minutes we will concentrate on what is arguments list. Here arguments list is nothing but one kind of input, as you can see on your screen. So arguments list is one kind of a variable with data type. Okay, what is arguments list? One kind of a variable with a data type that is called arguments list, and it is called as input. So function identity is my function, as you can see on your with the help of example. Add is my function, and argument list, you can compare with that example integer x and integer y. Here x and y are the variables, and integer is my data type. Okay, so arguments list is nothing but combination of, collection of, or set of, or only single number of arguments will be there. So that arguments list is nothing but input to the functions. So here is my function name. My function name is identity, and my argument list is input to the function. The same syntax we can compare with the example. Here my function name is add is my function name. Okay, and my argument list integer x, integer y. Okay, all right, till now just concentrate. Okay, hold on. Here return type, as you can see in the red color, we called it as output, right? So you can see in like syntax, you can see like identity is my function name, argument list is my input, and the return type is my output. So in between that curly brace and open and close curly brace, you can see the processing logic. Okay, concentrate guys, just focus on the example. Here I wanted to perform the addition of two numbers. Okay, I wanted to perform addition of two numbers, so definitely we need two numbers. Okay, if I want to perform the addition of two numbers, in that case we need two values, because one value and another one value. Okay, we need two value for addition operations. Okay, for example, we take 10 and the 20. So these two values we need to perform the addition. Okay, so 10 will be stored into x, as you can see on your screen. 10 will be stored into x, and 20 will be stored into y. Okay, so that value 10 and 20, we are considering it as arguments. Now, as you can see on your screen, integer x and integer y with the help of example. So 10 and 20, we were considering it as a arguments, and that arguments is providing as an input to the addition functions. Okay, so when we provide as an input to the addition functions, the control switch to inside the function, and you can see int z equals to x plus y. Here z is the third variable we are using. For what purpose? We are using integer z variable to store the result. Means when we perform the operation x plus y, means 10 plus 20, the result of 30 will be stored into z. Okay, now we not get the output. So the next line you can see on your screen, the return z. So return z is nothing but your output, and that output is what type of output? It is integer type of output, because 10 plus 10 equals to 30, and 30 is integer value, as we have seen in the concept of data types, right? So 10 plus 20 equals to 30, and the 30 is my integer value, and that particular results will return as a integer. That's why I am using here int add, int x, and int y argument list. So int is nothing but my return type. So because why I'm using here return type, because the function returning as a result in terms of integer value. So I am recalling it again, and we'll focus again and again in this topic, because once you understand this, then we will understand the upcoming like concept in functions. Okay, all right. So you can see on your screen, identity is my function, as we focus on the syntax, identity is my function, and it is a completely function name. As you can see on your screen, function name means it is user defined. Instead of identity, you can use your name. Instead of identity, you can use your village name, your city name, your like anything, any type of operation. If you want to perform, you can use here. Suppose you wanted to perform the operation like subtraction, you can use your subtraction as a function name. And you wanted to perform subtraction on three numbers, you can use argument list integer x, integer y, integer z also there. You can see on your screen. Okay, just focus. Compare this both syntax and example. Okay, so argument list is nothing but, remember, argument list is nothing but input, function, argument list, and return type. So here return type is nothing but my output. So these three important part you can observe in each and every functions. In each and every function you can find out these three points, three important part, and that three important part is responsible to execute the functions. Means identity, inside that identity we have processing logic. Okay, now compare this syntax with example. Here add is my function and the processing logic is integer z equals to x plus y return z. So this is my processing logic. Okay, starting with open curly brace and ends with a close curly brace. Input values, input values are integer x, integer y. These are my input values. And my result store into z, and my result is a type of integer. That's why I'm providing a return type as a integer to the functions add. Guys, now the standard definition, the understandable definition you can see on your screen. What is the function? The function is a set or block. Okay, a function is the set of instruction, or function is a block of instructions having identity with which is taking input, comma processing the input and producing the output. Okay, so this definition again we compare with example. We have the function add. That function add is having number of instruction like integer z equals to x plus y return z vagera vagera. Okay, so we have function add. That function is having number of instructions or set of instructions, and that functions having identity. Identity is that function name. That function name is add, which is taking input, which is taking input from where it is taking input. It is taking input from their argument list like integer x, integer y. So here, which is taking input integer x and integer y, come up processing. So mute everyone. Come up processing. Come up processing means here processing logic you can see on your screen, integer z equals to x plus y return z. These are the processing logic. So when the function taking an input and processing that input as per the requirement of a function and producing the output in terms of the result, you can see on your screen quite easily. You need to understand it logically and diagrammatically. Okay, till now, if is it okay? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Return type, ek bar bataiye. Return type.
Yeah. Return type is nothing but your output. Okay. It will generate it only on behalf of the result which is produced by processing logic. Means what? Inside your function like open and close curly brace, inside whatever the logic you are implementing. Here I am using addition of two number. Two numbers are x and y. Sometimes somewhere you can use like performing some addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay. So on the basis of that processing logic, your result will generate, right? And that result will store somewhere, because whatever the result you have generated, that result definitely we need to store somewhere, because that result needs some kind of memory allocation, some kind of address should be there. So here z, integer z is my third variable. Okay, and whatever the result produces by x plus y, that result will be stored into z. Now here we need to focus, guys. Here we need to focus. Suppose the result in terms of float point value means decimal point value. Okay, so in that case, my return type should be float instead of int. Okay, but here in example, you can see integer x and integer y. So integer x equals to 10 and integer y equals to 20, and performing operation inside the function by identifying open and close curly brace. Performing operation, which operation I'm performing here? I'm performing here the operation of addition. Okay, and the values are x equals to 10 and y equals to 20. After performing addition, the result will be 30. Okay, and the 30 will be stored into z. But here as a programmer, we need to focus on the result. 30 value is a float type? No. 30 value is a character type? No. 30 value is an integer type? Yes,
it is. Yes.
Integer type, right? So in that case, returning z means returning, or return z means that value should, that value is returning to the function, and that result is returning to function because 30 or the result will be stored into z. But if we concentrate on the value of z, so it is in terms of integer value. That's why I'm using here return type as a integer. Getting? So return type is completely depends on the processing logic result type of data or type of the values.
Sir?
Yes.
Variable
so return type or data type same ही हुआ ना मतलब
return type और data type same बिल्कुल कभी नहीं होगा. कभी भी return type function के पहले आएगा, data type function के बाद आएगा. आप जो देख रहे हो integer x, integer y, here these are not considering as a data type, we are considering it as a arguments list. और कोई भी function के पहले, कोई भी function के पहले अगर कोई भी data type use होता है, चाहे फिर वो इंटीजर, फ्लोट, कैरेक्टर, डबल, शॉर्ट, स्ट्रिंग, वॉइड, इन फ्रंट ऑफ और द फ्रंट साइड ऑफ एनी फंक्शन, इफ देयर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनी डेटा टाइप, वी कैन नॉट कॉल्ड इट एज अ डेटा टाइप, वी कॉल्ड इट एज अ रिटर्न टाइप. गुड क्वेश्चन, बट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इट. हियर इंटीजर, देन एड, देन इंटीजर एक्स एंड इंटीजर वाई. दिस इंटीजर एक्स एंड इंटीजर वाई आर द आर्गुमेंट्स. ओके, प्रोवाइडिंग इनपुट टू द फंक्शन, processing logic and generating output. So yeah, how you can remember, how you can identify return type, how you can identify the difference between return type and data type? Return type always a single word in front of any function name. Here you can see int, add, integer x, integer y, these are the argument list, but you can see int is a single word in front, in front side of any like function name. You can see here identity, return types, and arguments list. So there will be difference. Okay, just hold on. Generally,
sir, मतलब return type
है. Yes.
Memory allocation के लिए use करते हैं. अगर allocate नहीं किया होते.
Return type memory allocation के लिए? नहीं. Memory allocation तो result में ही कर रहे हैं ना.
नहीं sir, on behalf of memory allocation.
No. Return type
is used.
Yes. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just concentrate. If you focus on your screen, you can see the difference between return type and data type. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
You can see, sir, on your screen, integer A, float B, character C, and so on. Okay. So integer A is my variable, integer my data type here. Okay. But if you focus on the syntax of functions, you can see integer, and that add is my function name, and integer X and integer Y are my arguments list. So you can see here integer A, float B are the separate data types and variable, but where is integer add means those data types sitting in front of any function name, we called it as a return type.
Clear? Yes, sir. Got it now. Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. Okay. Till now, have any question? Have you, everyone understand it?
Hello,
yes,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, no, sir, you fully cleared.
Yes, yes, yes.
Question, sir. सर इंट ऐड के बाद में जो ब्रैकेट में आपने इंट एक्स इंट वाई लिखा है वो हम सर नीचे कर्ली ब्रेसेस में भी डिक्लेयर कर सकते हैं ना
कौन सा
वो इंट ऐड के बाद में जो आपने लिखा है इंट एक्स इंट वाई वो हम नीचे भी मतलब डिक्लेयर कर सकते हैं ना
आप नीचे भी डिक्लेयर कर सकते हो अगर आप सपोज फंक्शन को एम्प्टी रखना चाहते हो तो वो एक अलग टाइप का फंक्शन है वो सारे के चारों टाइप हम देखने वाले हैं अभी 10-15 मिनट में ठीक है मैंने कंप्लीट आपको इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू गाइस मैंने आपके सामने पूरा सिंटैक्स रखा है फंक्शन का ठीक है आप उसको फंक्शन के अंदर भी यूज कर सकते हो इंट एक्स इंट वाई एज अ लोकल वेरिएबल यू कैन मैनिपुलेट एनीथिंग इन प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज यू आर फ्री टू वर्क
यस
यू आर फ्री टू वर्क होल्ड ऑन विजिबल क्यों नहीं है क्या हो गया यू आर फ्री टू वर्क गेटिंग बट हियर इज द कंप्लीट सिंटैक्स ऑफ फंक्शंस यू कैन फाइंड आउट समवेयर रिटर्न टाइप यू कैन फाइंड आउट यू डेफिनेटली फंक्शन नेम विल बी देयर दैट आइडेंटिटी विल बी देयर एंड आर्गुमेंट लिस्ट इज देयर टिल नाउ व्हाटएवर द थिंग्स वी डिस्कस फ्रॉम लास्ट 10 टू 15 मिनट्स इज दैट क्लियर एवरीवन आई एम रिकॉलिंग इट अगेन इज दैट क्लियर इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क वी कैन रिकॉल इट
No, sir. Clear, clear, clear.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
Sir, x yes. and y की वैल्यू कहाँ डिक्लेयर करेंगे अपन?
वो देखते ना अभी.
हाँ ठीक है.
यू वैल्यू को हम कैसे डिक्लेयर करते हैं? At the time of execution, जिसे कहते हैं कंपाइल टाइम, रन टाइम, वो टाइम पे हम उसको वैल्यू प्रोवाइड करते हैं. We are not providing okay, here any value. Right, right, right. Okay. So this is the just simple syntax of function. And its implementation process. You can see here, you need to remember these three things rigorously. That is the syntax of functions, function name, that is nothing but the identity of functions, argument list, we call it as an input. Argument list ko kabhi bhi dhyan mein rakhna hai aap logo ko. We call it as input. Argument list is nothing but input to the function. Argument list is nothing but input to the functions. Argument list is nothing but input to the functions. Okay, and the return type is nothing but my output. Return type is nothing but my output. Unless and until we provide as a return type, that function will not return any kind of output. If the function or the processing logic generating any value, depends, right? So return type is my output. So with the help of example, you can easily understand this whole syntax of functions. Addition is my identity. Integer x, integer y are my input values and int in front of addition int is my return type and inside that open and close curly brace in add function you can see integer z equals to x plus y return z these are my processing logic okay if we come up these 3 to 4 points over there the function the definition for function the standard definition for function you can see here guys in a book you can find out the definition for function like function is a set of instruction or function is a block or the function is a collection of variables and the functions function is a collection of variables and some processing logic this kind of definition you can find in a book but this definition is completely logical definition once in terms of like if there is an interview and there will be a question like what is the function and if you return such a definition in front of this interviewer he will definitely, I'm sure with my experience he will never ask you the second question on the concept of functions so what is the definition of function the function is set of instruction right the function is the set of instructions having identity means the function is having their name okay the function is a set of instructions having identity which is taking input which is a taking input means which is taking argument list as a input come up processing means inside that function that processing that logic that is nothing but integer z x plus y return z so come up processing the input and producing the output as you can see if you focus on this color combination identity as I use green color to to the function name as identity, as I use the like purple color to the argument list, and as I use like red color to the return type, you can easily compare this definition with these three parameters, that is function name, input, and output. So this is a complete logical definition, and everyone should write it in exam also, and everyone should like remember lifelong. So the function is the set of instructions having identity. Means function is having that, definitely there will be name of that function, which is taking input, means there will be some kind of arguments over there as an input. Comma processing means that input has been processed inside the function. Inside the function means in between that open and close curly brace. Okay, and producing the output in terms of return type. I hope I'm recalling it again and again. So everyone is like clear with that concept. Can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
We can recall it. Otherwise, yes, we can move forward. Yeah. Okay. All right, guys. So this is all about the functions. So what is the function? The function is nothing but a set of instructions having identity. Which is, yeah. Yes. Okay, mute everyone. So what is the function? The function is the set of instructions having identity, which is taking input, comma processing the input, and producing the output. That is nothing but the complete definition of function. Okay, and this definition of functions you can use in any type of programming language, whether you talk about Java, whether you talk about .NET, whether you talk about any like PHP or any programming language, the same concept you can find over there. So function, but difference is what? In function, C programming or C++ programming language, we called it as a function. In Java programming, we called it as a method. That is the only difference over there. So this is all about the function and its identification. How you can identify function? You can identify function by using their function name, argument list, and return type, and their processing logic inside of that open and close curly brace. If such a kind of code is there, then you should understand, like you should be able to understand, this is the complete functions in a programming language. You can see here. Okay, so guys, in detail we will see again with the help of example what purpose we are using functions, what is the need of functions, how we can use functions, what is the definition of function, and then function call. You can see on your screen, just take an example of function definition of TV. Television, everyone is known with that concept of TV. Everyone using that device in your home or your room or hostel, you can use that. Okay, so we know that the use of television. So we just general example we are covering here to understand again in more deep manner what is the function and why, what is the purpose we are using the function in programming language everywhere. Okay, all right, you can see on your screen the small functions we use in your day-to-day televisions, like power on, power off, channel change, volume plus or volume minus. You can see here one function of a TV, that is TV automatically TV get power on? No, so we need to power it on. So for that one functions we use over there. If you want to switch off the TV, then there will be one function, that is off function will be there, right? If you want to change the channel, you can use, we have one channel functions over there. If you want to increase or decrease the volume of your TV, you can use that volume functions in front of your guys. So these basic four functions we are using in front of you. So whatever the logic required inside that to set the power on to the TV, power off to the TV, making a channel change from like one channel to another channel, or to increase the volume or decrease the volume. So whatever the logic needed or whatever the logic is required, that logic is present inside this function. Inside this function means inside the volume functions, inside the channel functions, inside the switch on, switch off functions, as you can see. So these four functions. Okay, so are you thinking like that function definition is important? No. For example, suppose we have like mobile phone. Okay, we know that we use mobile phone for calling purpose, some accessing internet and all that things. Okay, we have mobile phone, but we don't have any calls, we don't doing any return callback, or we don't receive any calls. So is that mobile phone is important for you? I don't think so. If there will be no call received, no call dial, or not any kind of use there, so the mobile phone is completely useless. Means mobile phone is present, you have defined your mobile phone, means your definition is complete. But there is one important concept, or there is one important terminology in programming, that is, you can see on your screen, function call. You wanted to off your TV, that time you need to call off functions. If you wanted to change the channel, that time you need to call change the channel functions. If you want to increase your volume of your TV, that time you need to call the function of volume. So something will be there that is responsible to activate that functions. You can see on your screen. So you can compare these four functions with your remote control, as you can see. So once, if you want to change the channel, you can see on your screen. If you want to change the channel, you use your remote control and press the button of your remote control, change the channel. If you want to positive channel or negative channel, means if you want to forward or backward. So depends on your requirement. You are using, you are pressing a button of change the channel, as you can see. So once you press the button as a change the channel, okay, so the function of channel will activate, and that it perform the operation which is available inside that function, that is in terms of processing logic. Once you press the channel button, so that channel function will be activate. During the same time, on, off and volume, both the three functions will be like is in the idle state. They will not work anything, because same times that function, channel function is working. So here you have defined on, off, channel and volume. These four functions you have defined very well, but with that we need to call that functions to perform operations, right? I hope you understand with this simple example. So guys, you can see one note here in front of you. Not only definition is important to the functions, right? Not only definition is important to the functions, along with the function calling is also important. Because once you define, for example, again, we take an example. Okay, we will take again example, like for example, like in front of my one water bottle is there. Okay, it fill up with a specific amount of water over there, but I'm not using it. I'm not opening it. I'm not taking the water. I'm not taking the benefit of that water. I'm not taking that as a drinking water. So what will be the use of that bottle, or what will be the use of the definition of bottle? I'm seeing it is a completely bottle fill up with specific level of water over there. I can see it, I can define it, but if I'm not calling it, but if I'm not using that bottle, so it is like just we define that function, it will not work. So to call that function, so function calling is very important. So same guys, in programming we need to focus on the function calling. So you can see here on your screen, not only definition is important to call the functions, but not only definition is important to the functions, along with the functions calling, it is also important. Means by your calling, that function will activate. As you can see on your screen, pressing the button of channel, the channel functions will be execute. Whatever the logic present inside that processing logic is present inside the channel function will be work, and then output will get. Otherwise we will not get output, because we just defined the function. For example, if you press here the volume button, okay, so the volume, once you press the volume button, that time that volume function will perform some operations, okay? So volume button is my function call, and volume is my function. So here my point to remember you, like here my point is to clear you that not only definition is important to the functions, along with the function calling is also important, as you can see on your screen. So these two points also, it's necessary we need to understand, right? Just we prepare the functions, it will not work, we need to call that functions, and that is two important point we will cover in upcoming 10 to 15 minutes. I hope you understand with this simple example. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, all right. Guys, we have very important point just concentrated here, classification of functions. Hold on. You can see on your screen the classification of functions. Guys, there are four classification of functions. There are four classification of functions means you can use a function or you can define function or you can implement function in programming language in these four different ways. So concentrate, very important. There are four classification of functions. Not only in C programming language, this classification of functions or methods are available in all type of programming languages. So it means those concepts that you are studying right now, that concept you can find everywhere in any programming language. Same concept variable you can find everywhere in any programming language. Okay, so concentrate. There are four classification of functions in C programming language. Not only in C programming language, every language is having this kind of implementation of functions. Okay, so any function belongs to the following four type of categories. The first one, no arguments and no return value. What is the syntax of functions? You can see on your screen. What is the syntax of function? Function name. Okay, function name, anyone? Function name.
Sir, function
argument list.
Yes.
Argument list.
Return type. Yes, return type. Right, this is my simple function.
Yeah.
So function name, argument list and return type. Okay, just concentrate. So here you can see any function belong to the following four type of categories. Just mute everyone. No arguments and no return value. Right, no arguments and no return value. First category means you can find out there will be not any kind of arguments, not any return value. Okay, with arguments and no return value. With arguments, no return value. Okay, then third category, with arguments and with return value. And the fourth category, no arguments and with return value. So this concept of function is completely playing in between argument list and return value. Argument list, return value means nothing but return type. Okay, return value is nothing but return type. Okay, I'm recalling it again. Return value means return type. Okay, so here you can see here the function is completely playing in between argument list and return value, right? Sometimes you can find argument list is there, return type is also there, return value is also there, function is there. Sometimes you can find argument list available nahi, but return value available. Okay, sometimes you can see argument list is there, return type is also there. Sometimes you will see no arguments but return type is there. So these four category we will understand in more deeply. Just concentrate, focus. Okay, you can see again the definition of function. What is the definition of function? The function is the block of instruction, or function is the set of instruction having identity which is taking input, comma processing the input and producing the output. You can see here guys, here arguments are nothing but input.
Input
values, and the return is nothing but our
output
values, right? You can see here. So remember, all time any function, if there is an argument list, then that argument list is nothing but our input. Or any function, if there is a return type, then that return type is nothing but our output. So you can find these things in any functions. Okay, we have four type of categories of functions. That first one, no arguments and no return value. With arguments, no return value. With arguments and with return value. No arguments and with return value. Okay, so first one, just compare first one. No arguments means there will be nothing any kind of input and there will be nothing any kind of output. First category, green color. No argument means no input, no output. Function will work. Okay. Second category, blue color, you can see on your screen. With arguments means definitely there will be one kind of any number kind of input, any character type of input over there. Okay. Generating result, but there is no need to provide as a return type value or any return value. So that function will execute. Okay. So you can see here input, no output means no return value. Okay. Third category, with arguments means list of arguments is there as an input, processing and returning value to the functions. Okay. Next one, fourth category, purple color, no arguments, but there will be some kind of processing was there and returning value to the functions. So these four category we will consider and we will understand with the help of example. Just three, four category we need to understand and remember. If there is a question in university question paper, what is the function? You need to write these four category by hook or to. If you miss anything, means you lost your 3 to 4 marks, definitely. Okay. So these four category you can find not only in C programming language, you can find everywhere in programming language like C++, Java, .NET, PHP, Salesforce, Python. You can find out everywhere these kind of functions. Okay. So again, I'm recalling the definition. What is the definition of function? The function is a set of block or set of instructions having identity, which is taking input, comma processing the input and processing the output. Comma processing the input means whatever the input that function has been taking, inside that function it processes that input. We called it as a processing logic, just we seen in previous slide. Okay, is that clear, guys?
Sir?
Yes, sir. Clear. Yes,
sir. Sir, yeah. There is a question.
Yeah, one question. Yes.
Sir, at fourth classification time.
Yes.
Sir, how it's work? Because we are not giving input, and how we give output, sir?
Yes.
Because
to understand,
upon
to understand this. Yes. Okay, same I got question. Your question. I got your question.
Yes,
if
sir.
We are not providing any input value to the function, right?
Mm-hmm.
Some operations, yes, you can find some kind of operations you can find that operation no need any kind of input. For example, if I want to print my name, if I want to print one message like hi, welcome to SHGMC, we can use any statement. Yes. Like printf, right? Printf.
Yes, sir, right.
Printf is a function. So if we use that single statement printf into that function, so is there any requirement to provide any input to that function?
No sir.
That function will execute or not?
It executes, sir.
Definitely it will execute. Without any input, that function will execute because that function carrying some kind of processing logic. That processing logic is nothing but one printf statement is there. That statement having some kind of messages. So that message will execute without taking any input. So it's not mandatory. Yes.
Wo bhi input hi hoga na statement ya nahi?
Kya?
Wo jo statement hamne diya na.
सर इनपुट होगा ना प्रिंट
हाँ यस
यस
इट्स आउटपुट
यस व्हाट यू सेड यू कैन क्लियरली आस्क मी आई एम नॉट गेटिंग यू
सर दैट स्टेटमेंट वी प्रोवाइड इट इज आल्सो इनपुट ना
नो इट इज नॉट इनपुट इट इज इनपुट इट इज अ प्रोसेसिंग लॉजिक बट इन टर्म्स ऑफ लाइक आर्गुमेंट्स इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू प्रोवाइड देयर Because printf statement is having a different functionality and it execute automatically in any function. Here the importance is that if you are implementing any function like addition, okay, but you don't want to perform any kind of addition, you just need to provide any message or print any message, so you can use printf statement. Okay, printf enter any two numbers, but I'm not interested to perform addition, this is my result. So that printf statement will execute. We don't need to provide any as an input, as an argument list over there. Where we are using argument list, if you are performing some kind of operations like arithmetic operations, logical operations, so that time we are using that argument list. And these four type of categories we will see with the help of example and we will prove it. Getting?
Yes, sir.
So each
yes, argument sir.
Is not necessary to provide as an input, as you can see. No arguments, no return value. No arguments means no input, no output. but some kind of operation will be there in front, inside that function. That function will execute. Clear? Can we forward? Can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Just concentrate. I will cover this whole concept with the help of examples. Okay, with the help of examples, you can easily get this whole idea. Just concentrate. Okay. So the classification of functions. Just concentrate here, guys. With the help of example, you can easily understand this classification of functions. So is it visible? Blue color screen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Concentrate. As you can see on your screen, just hold on, guys. Hello. Any participants who are there? Okay, you can see on your screen classification of functions. These four classifications we have divided in these four types of examples and their implementation. Just concentrate, guys. You can easily understand the clarity. You can understand. Okay. So the first column, just focus over there. No arguments, no return value. First category, no arguments, no return value. Here you can see on your screen here. No return value, I use no. Here fun is nothing but my function name, and no return value, no. But in a C programming language, no is not a proper use of as a coding logic. No is not any kind of any like a keyword or any like processing word we are use ever in C programming language. So instead of that no, we use void.
Void.
Yeah, good. Instead of that, no, we use void, as you can see on your screen. Just concentrate. Instead of no, we used void. Means here you can see that there will be one function. That function name is fun. Okay. But we can find out here there is not any kind of input. So, and there is not any kind of return value. There is not any kind of results. So because of that, we called this kind of functions, we called it as no arguments and no return value. And these functions you can observe in programming everywhere, right? So just concentrate on the next second column. You can see with arguments and no return value. With arguments and no return value. Yeah, you can see here with arguments and no return value. With arguments means here you can see void is no return value. Means we use here void. Name of function is the function. Fun is my function name. And integer x is my input. That is nothing but we called it as arguments list. Okay, integer x. So here integer x I'm providing over there. I wanted to store that x into somewhere. So I use that integer x. Okay, that integer x will be processed inside these fun functions. And that integer x will be stored somewhere. Like, but what happening here? Here, we haven't used any return, not any return type value we are not using here. Why? Because that functions is returning any integer type of value. And that integer type of value is not like there is not any kind of a complications were there. That function does not observing any return value. The simple integer 10 value is there. So that's why that 10 during the function call, okay, that 10 will be stored into that x. Okay, with function call we will cover a little bit after 5 minutes. Just understand four types, and then we will focus on that function calling as an important part of that programming. You can see here second type with arguments and no return value. Here void function, and that function is having input x. And that x is nothing but one kind of value is processing to the processing logic. You can see. Okay. The third one, concentrate with arguments and with return value. With arguments and with return value means you can see here the complete definition of function. Means here integer is my return value. Character x is my input. And once you found any return type in front of any function, then there should be, you can find like return statement inside the processing logic, inside the functions. As you can see on your screen, fun is my function. Input is character X, returning value 13, and it is an integer type of value. That's why I'm providing here input X. Guys, guys, hold on, just important call. Yes, yes, sir. Lakshmi, work in the oh. चलो मेरे लिए चाय आ रही है, थैंक यू. ओके, यू कैन सी, जस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन थर्ड कॉलम. यू कैन सी विथ आर्गुमेंट्स एंड विथ रिटर्न वैल्यू, यू कैन सी हियर फंक्शन इज फन इज माय फंक्शन नेम, कैरेक्टर एक्स इज एज आर्गुमेंट लिस्ट एंड वी कॉलिंग इट एज इनपुट एंड प्रोड्यूसिंग आउटपुट इन टर्म्स ऑफ इंटीजर वैल्यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ दैट रिजल्ट. रिजल्ट इज वॉट, रिटर्निंग 13. यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन रिटर्निंग 13. सो दैट्स वाई रिटर्न टाइप इज देयर इंटीजर. ओके, डेफिनेटली आपके दिमाग में क्वेश्चन आ रहा होगा, वो उसको कवर करेंगे, राइट. जस्ट फोकस ऑन द नेक्स्ट वन, नो आर्गुमेंट्स एंड विथ रिटर्न वैल्यू. नो आर्गुमेंट्स विथ रिटर्न वैल्यू, नो आर्गुमेंट्स विथ रिटर्न वैल्यू. जस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट हियर, फन इज माई फंक्शन नेम, नो आर्गुमेंट्स, दैट्स वाई आई हैव यूज हियर वॉइड एज माई रिटर्न टाइप. ओके, नो आर्गुमेंट्स means there is absence of any arguments, there is not any kind of input, so that's why I use here as void. Okay, with return value, what is the return value? Here you can see after processing, after come up and processing the input inside the block, inside the functions, the result is 29.20. okay, that 29.20, the result, it is in terms of decimal point value, and that result is going to return to the functions. The value is a type of decimal point value, so that value can be supported by only float type of a data type. So because of that reason, I use here float as a return type. So you can see on your screen, float is a return type, fun is my function name, and void is nothing but there is not any kind of input, there is not any kind of arguments. So if you compare these four functions with the help of this classification, you can easily understand with the help of this example. No arguments, no return value. With arguments, no return value. With arguments, with return value. No arguments, with return value. Okay, so here you have provided input to, or you have defined the functions. Means you just complete the definition of functions. But here, what is our requirement? Now our requirement to call the functions. How we call the functions? Why we need to call the functions? We discussed just last previous slide with the help of example of television. Okay, without calling function, it will not execute. So concentrate on the first one, no arguments and no return value. Here, simply function will call. Simply function will call. Function, you can see on your screen the last row, first column, last row, function directly execute the fun function, and whatever the result inside that, it will be execute. For example, in fun function, if there is a statement like printf, okay, inside that printf, one message is there, hi. Okay, so that printf statement does not need any kind of like input values, like X, Y, or any kind of input value does not require, that printf statement will execute. Once you call the function fun, so that function will execute, as you can see on your screen. Just concentrate on the second one, with arguments and no return value. So here, no return value is there, but there is one kind of value that need to process by using the fun functions. So you can see here, integer X. So integer is a type of X wanted to store the integer type of value. So during the execution of program, during execution of a program, we are providing value to the argument during execution. I'm calling auting where, when we use that during the execution of a program, I'm providing value, which value? 10 value I'm providing. The 10 value will be stored into X and your function will execute. So you can see to call the first one function, we use the function name. Again, in second column, you can see to call the second one like with arguments and no return value. That time also we call the function by its name. That is the fun. So that's why function identity is very important. Because of that identity, we can call the functions by their name. So it is not possible to randomly call any functions without knowing that function name. So now you can understand the importance of function name in a programming language. So it should be unique. So many features were there. We will discuss that. So the function name is important. Why you are using the function name? Because function name, because of that function name, we can call that functions. Same example we have seen in the previous example, like television. To change the channel, we press the channel button. So because of that channel button, the channel function is executed. So this kind of programming, this kind of implementation process, this kind of language we are using in programming, we called it as standardness of that programming or the standardness of that application, because that function name should be related to the operation. Guys, if I wanted to perform addition, that function name like should be add, sum, or any, but that function name should reflect their like features. If you wanted to perform like division, that function name should be division or any name that is relevant to that functions. If you wanted to perform some kind of average, if you want to perform some average, so that function name should be like average, like whatever the processing logic inside that function, it should be related to that function name. So because of that, you can easily identify and you can call that functions. In both the column, you can see here, if you want to call the function, means if you want to execute the function, we use the function name. Okay, but in the second column, here is the argument list is having one value that is integer type of value. So during the execution of that functions, we provide the value to that 10. And the 10 will be stored into x, as you can see. So input x equals to 10, you can see on your screen. Okay, so before moving the third column, if you have any question, you can ask right now.
सर अगर फर्स्ट में हमने प्रिंट एफ हाई लिखा है ना तो वो वैसे का वैसे ही डिस्प्ले होगा ना
यस
यू डोंट रिटर्न इट
उसको कोई रिटर्न टाइप की जरूरत नहीं है और ना ही उसको कोई इनपुट वैल्यू की जरूरत है मैंने जस्ट एग्जांपल के तौर पर बताया कि वो फंक्शन विदाउट रिटर्न वैल्यू और विदाउट आर्गुमेंट लिस्ट भी एग्जीक्यूट कैसे होता है तो कुछ ऐसे एग्जीक्यूटेबल स्टेटमेंट होते हैं जो हमारे प्रोग्रामिंग में हम डे टू डे यूज करते हैं अगर कुछ नहीं भी रहा तो वो एग्जीक्यूट होते हैं जैसे कि प्रिंट एफ स्टेटमेंट है ओके इज देयर एनी क्वेश्चन बिफोर मूविंग थर्ड कॉलम आई नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड लाइक दिस टू कॉलम्स यू अंडरस्टैंड एवरीवन अंडरस्टैंड वेरी वेल
सर रिपीट सेकंड कॉलम
ओके विद आर्गुमेंट्स एंड नो रिटर्न वैल्यू विद आर्गुमेंट्स एंड नो रिटर्न वैल्यू मींस देयर विल बी सम काइंड ऑफ इनपुट बट नॉट एनी रिटर्न टाइप right not any return type as you can see on your screen here input x integer you can see on your screen integer x as arguments right means some kind of value we have to provide and it is what type of value it should be integer type of value so when you call that function okay second column last row focus on there fun inside that 10 when we calling that function that time we are providing value as a 10 why we are providing value as a 10 because it is integer type of input integer type of arguments and it the x value should be integer type because its data type is integer so that's why I am providing here 10 as a value and that 10 will be stored into The 10 will be stored into 10 will be stored into x, right? And does not returning any value. That function will execute. The 10 will be stored into x because we haven't perform any operation over there. We just store value into x, right? So such a kind of operation we can use with the help of these kind of functions with arguments, no return value. Yes. Can we move forward, guys?
Yes, sir.
Everyone got this? Yes, sir. If you have any questions?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. All right. Concentrate. With these two, again, example, you will get whole idea. And with the help of program, you will get complete idea. Okay? Just concentrate. With arguments and with return value. With arguments and with return value. Third column, just concentrate over there. You can see here, with arguments with return value means there is input value and there is one return type also. Okay? So you can see here, function name is fun, mute everyone. Function is my function name. Character X. X is a variable which is going to store any character. Okay. And taking input by that function as a processing logic, you can see, and generating result like 13. And returning to the functions as an integer value. Okay. Once you call that function, that time, what will happen here? Concentrate, guys. It is a character type of variable. Okay. So we know that character data type, and we are providing value in between single quotations. If you want to store any character, we are providing that single quotation value. So here I wanted to store single character S into X. As you can see on your screen, I provide during the calling functions, I provide yes to the X. What will happen? So S will directly store into X. Okay. But what happening here? The S will be stored into X. It is a character type. But you can see on your screen the result or the value, return value is the 13. Okay. So if the value return is a 13, that 13 value should be stored somewhere because it is an integer value. So that's why I use here one integer X equals to function S. So now the question is what? You definitely one question in your mind that, sir, if we are storing a character value and generating results in a integer value and return type is integer type, why not there should be integer return type should be character, right? This kind of questions is your mind. I hope every mujhe lagta hai ki aapke dimag mein question aa jana chahiye ki agar suppose result integer mein generate ho raha hai but storing to character ho raha hai. So guys, returning or the results input and the return value, definitely there will be different, you can find in different implementation process or different programming logic. To understand this, just one example we will consider. Like in front of ATM machine, we are providing some number like your PIN numbers or account numbers or whatever the processing process you have performed. Okay, you provide number like integer numbers will be there, like PIN number in terms of integers. And as an output, you get money. Right? Another one example, like हमारे day to day life में हम जैसे किसी shop पे जाते हैं, कपड़े खरीदते हैं, okay? Purchasing some clothes. That time we, as an input, we provide as a money to that shop owner, right? And taking some clothes. So in any programming language, there will be no correlation or relation, any kind of relation. There is not any kind of relation in between input and output. Definitely in a programming language, input will be different and output will be different. So these two examples is sufficient to understand. So here we are storing input value as a character, but performing some operation, whatever the operation inside that function, we don't know. Right now, this is just understanding point of view, but in a program, only single operation is there? No, multiple thousands of operations were there. So depends on that operation, depends on that result, that value should return to the functions. So here in front of you, that's why I'm putting this specific concept over you. Here I'm storing a character into X. That character is S. But after processing, the value is generated. That value is a 13, as you can see on your screen. So if the value is generated is a 13, we know that 13 is an integer type of value. If the 13 is an integer type of value, then definitely we need to store that somewhere, 13. So that's why in calling functions, you can see in third column, third row, third column, first row, you can see integer X. the 13 will be stored into integer x, and whatever the operations performing were there, that result will return as a function and that function will execute. I hope you got this complete whole point. Means it's not mandatory that you are providing input as a character, so the output will be definitely you can find out as a character. No, you can provide any kind of input, the output can be generated any kind of. So the return value is a 13. That's why I use a return type as an integer. Very deep concept, but important concept. So if the return value is generated as a 13, so that's why the 13 should be stored somewhere. I use integer x equals to fun. Here during the function calling, I calling the function like fun. Okay, providing value as a s, generating result as a 13, and the 13 is stored somewhere, and that 13 is an integer type of value. That's why I'm using here integer as a return type. Is that clear, guys? A little bit deep, yes, concept, sir. But you need to understand it. Yeah, any question? मैं इसको recall कर दूँगा अगर आपको नहीं समझा.
तो पीछे वाली slide में return type और int same color में लिखा था ना?
नहीं color तो वो तो आपको understand करने के लिए मैंने identify करने के लिए use किया है. अब ऐसा नहीं है कि हर जगह पे आप same logic पकड़ के चलोगे. You should be flexible in programming language. अभी data type अब अगर argument list को आप data type बोल के चलोगे तो कैसे चलेगा? Data type अलग जगह भी use करते हैं हम लोग, right? ये argument list इसका implementation थोड़ा सा difference है. आपको different दिख रहा है ना, क्योंकि ये bracket के अंदर हम इसको declare कर रहे हैं.
Argument list को
function के अंदर हम उसको declare कर रहे हैं. That's why we called it as return type.
Argument list.
Right? जो भी data type हमने देखा, integer, character, float, short, double वगैरह वगैरह. ये सारे हमने देखे हैं. हम उसको बोलते हैं data type. अगर हम उसका implementation देखेंगे तो हम उसको function के सामने use कर रहे हैं. तो उसका yes, जो sir. अभी थोड़ा सा अलग है. अभी मैं आपके आपका अभी मैं टीचर हूँ, घर पे जाके मैं मतलब किसी का लाइक बेटा हो जाऊंगा, है ना. होटल पे जाके मैं किसी का कस्टमर हो जाऊंगा खाना खाते टाइम. मतलब हमारे रोल चेंज होते हैं ना, बट हम तो हम ही है ना. तो सेम कंसेप्ट अगर हम इसको कंपेयर करते हैं, तो जैसे जैसे जिस जिस जगह पे हम जिस चीज को इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं, वो जगह पे उसका फंक्शन जो है, उसका इम्प्लीमेंटेशन वो चेंज होता है. क्लियर? सो ये क्वेश्चन, ये पॉइंट आपके सामने रखने के पीछे का इंटेंशन ये है कि जो इनपुट को हम कंसिडर करके चलते हैं कि ये इनपुट दे रहा तो मेरा आउटपुट भी यही आएगा. नॉट मैंडेटरी कि वो ऐसा ही होगा. जैसे हम यहाँ पे कैरेक्टर इनपुट दे रहे हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल इनसाइड दैट फन फंक्शन देयर विल बी सम काइंड ऑफ ऑपरेशंस ऑन कैरेक्टर लाइक कॉन्कैटेनेशन ऑपरेशंस, एंड देन रिजल्ट वी वांट टू शो हाउ मेनी कैरेक्टर्स वी हैव एडेड. द रिजल्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ यू विल गेट 13 characters you have added, and the result will be shown to the screen. But if it is in terms of integer results, that return type should be integer. Point is that whatever the results has been generated by the functions, or whatever the return value has been generated by the functions, that return value is nothing but my return type to the functions. Otherwise, you will get like definitely error you can find. Right? Getting? Guys?
Yes, sir.
Are you Zhoble ka sarva?
Yes, no, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nice, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Kuch zyada ho raha hai kya? Kuch aisa ho raha hai kya?
No, sir.
Understanding mein nahi aa raha hai kya? Recall karu? किसी को क्वेश्चन होगा तो करो, अदरवाइज म्यूट करो. म्यूट 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 अगर मैं बोल रहा हूँ, अगर आपको ये समझ में नहीं आ रहा तो क्या मैं वापस से रिकॉल करूँ इसे?
यस सर.
यस,
क्या चाहिए आपको? कौन सा रिकॉल करूँ? फर्स्ट, सेकंड, थर्ड?
थर्ड वन सर.
थर्ड
वन.
देखो, कॉन्सेंट्रेट करना है आपको डेफिनेशन पे. What is the definition of third one? With arguments and with return value, right? So here you can see character x is my argument list. Okay, integer is my return value. Means you can see that after the performing any operation, after calling the function, that return value is in form of integer, and that input value in form of character. Okay, so once I call the functions, once I call the functions fun, so that time I need to provide value. I know that it is a character type of value. So that time I am going to provide here one single character, that is S in a single quotation, as you can see. Okay. So the input is what? X equals to S. So S will be stored into X, as you can see. Okay. After S will be stored into X, the input taking the functions and performing some operations inside that function from open curly brace to close curly brace. Focus karo third column pe. Right. So after performing some operation, kya operation ho raha hai mujhe pata nahi hai uske andar. Theek hai. But wo sara operation perform karne ke baad mujhe ek result mil raha hai jo hai 13. Value kya mil rahi hai mujhe? 13. Ab ye kaun se type ki value hai? It is integer type of value. Okay. So 13 value hai, integer type of value hai, to definitely meri responsibility hai ki value ko mujhe kahin to bhi store karna padega kyunki result ho raha hai. Ab we know that if any kind of operation perform, if whatever the result is there, we need to store it. So 13 ko store karne ke liye mujhe ek variable lagega aur uske liye ek data type lagega. So 13 is a which type of value? It is integer type of value, right? So that's why integer x, we have taken one variable with data type integer. So integer x will store the 13. 13 will store into x. Okay. And that function will execute as s. And that result is returning to the function integer func's character x. So this kind of program you can find in future, like everywhere, these kind of things. So now my point is to clear you that don't misunderstand, like if you are providing input as a character, so the return value or the result is in terms of character will be there. No, result can be integer, result can be float, because multiple operations is there, guys. Inside the functions there is not a single operation you can perform. You can perform thousands of operations for there. Thousands of operations present in one single functions you can perform there. Depends on the requirement you are performing the operations. So the result can be definitely different. So that different result as a return type. So here is the result is 13. So the 13 is integer type of value and returning to the functions. That's why integer is a return value or return type. Is that clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry. Yeah. Everyone, don't worry. इसको बस ध्यान में रखना है हमें कि input कुछ भी रहा तो भी output कुछ भी हो सकता है. ऐसा नहीं है कि मेरा input character है तो मुझे output भी character ही मिलेगा. Input integer है तो output मुझे integer ही मिलेगा. For example, अगर suppose यहाँ पे मुझे integer value देना है और मुझे perform करना है average, आपका percentage निकालना है मुझे, ठीक है? तो definitely percentage तो decimal point value में आएगा, है ना? तो अगर परसेंटेज डेसिमल पॉइंट में अलग, क्योंकि मार्क्स हम इनपुट एज ए इंटीजर देते हैं, जैसे फिजिक्स में 90 है, केमिस्ट्री में आपके समथिंग लाइक 98 है, मैथमेटिक्स में आपके 35 है, ठीक है?
ओके.
हाँ, और आपके मराठी इंग्लिश जो लैंग्वेज है उसमें आपके अच्छे खासे 45-50 मार्क्स है, ठीक है? तो ये सारे मार्क्स जो हम प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं एज ए इनपुट, वो तो सारे इंटीजर वैल्यू है. बट मुझे ऑपरेशन कौन सा परफॉर्म करना है? मुझे ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म करना है एवरेज का, आपके परसेंटेज निकालने हैं. तो आपके परसेंटेज आपको भी पता है कि पॉइंट्स में आते हैं, तो रिजल्ट कैसे जनरेट होगा मेरा?
फ्लोट
में. तो मेरा रिटर्न टाइप क्या रहेगा? नाउ यू गेटिंग?
यस सर.
व्हाटएवर द रिजल्ट,
यस सर,
13, टू स्टोर द 13 वी नीड टू यूज To store the 13, we need to use different variable. Same like whatever the average, मतलब जो भी आपका percentage है, उसको store करने के लिए भी मुझे एक variable लगेगा, right? और उस variable को उस type का data लगेगा. अब आपका average suppose आपके percentage आ गए 36.39, ठीक है? अब वो 36.39 percentage मुझे store करने के लिए definitely मुझे एक variable लगेगा. So मैं उसको consider करता हूँ x, और मेरा data type क्या रहेगा? Data type float रहेगा. अब वो जो रिजल्ट है आपका, जो आपका परसेंटेज है, आपने मेहनत की, इतनी पढ़ाई की, इतनी मेहनत के बाद आपको इतना अच्छा खासा 36% का रिजल्ट आ गया. अब उसको अगर स्टोर करना है, राइट, तो उसको स्टोर करने के लिए उसको तो स्टोर करना पड़ेगा ना, मार्कशीट पे कहीं पे तो भी दिखाना पड़ेगा, बोल्ड लेटर कैपिटल में, ठीक है? तो वो दिखाने के लिए हम क्या यूज करेंगे? उसको स्टोर करने के लिए हम एक डेटा टाइप यूज करेंगे, वो भी फ्लोट टाइप का, और वेरिएबल यूज करेंगे इंटीजर एक्स. getting?
Yes, sir.
Can you recall it? Who's that? Yes. Can you recall it? Yes. Anyone? Anyone? क्या बोले आप? अरे बोलना. Here I am putting my lot of energy in front of you. और आप कुछ बोल भी नहीं रहे हो. क्या बोले आप? Yes. Okay, can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
अरे सबकी आवाज आ रही मुझे.
Yes, sir.
क्या बात?
Yes, sir.
ये लास्ट वाला आवाज किसका था? इसके पहले का? Yes. Second last. Sanket.
Yes,
Sanket.
Yes, sir.
आपके पहले किसने बात किया?
Who's that? I'm Sanket.
Yeah, I know Sanket. Sanket was not there. आपके पहले किसने बोला yes sir? ये सारी चीजें मुझे नहीं चलेंगी. मैं लास्ट बार बता रहा हूँ, नहीं तो सीपी का सिलेबस डिक्लेयर कर दूंगा. ओके. और जो भी आप एज अ स्टूडेंट जो भी आप इनपुट देना चाहते हो ना, वो अपनी मतलब अपनी जो भी पढ़ाई है ना, उस पे दे दो. गेटिंग या नहीं? हाँ, अगर आपको कुछ लगता है कि हाँ मैं थोड़ा सा कम गिर रहा हूँ, आपको ये समझना चाहिए, यू कैन आस्क मी. I can spend not more than 1 hour. I can spend 2 to 3 hours in front of you. There is no matter. But my intention, you should understand it for your career, not only. And this is for everyone. I hope you understand in short language. Once I identify that, like Faltugiri, once I identify, I assured you, पूरी इंजीनियरिंग फर्स्ट ईयर में निकालोगे. इफ यू हैव एनी डिफिकल्टी यू कैन आस्क मी एट एनी टाइम. ओके, कॉन्सेंट्रेट. ओके, छोड़ो, चलो. Concentrate on the fourth one. Yes, guys, can we move on the fourth column? Or वापस ही इसी angry mood में चले जाएं?
Yes, sir. Fourth column पे.
Fourth column.
Yeah. Right. No arguments. No arguments and with written value. Yeah. No arguments and with written value. You can see on your screen, guys. Float. Here, written type is a float. And function name is a fun and without any arguments. So kind of operations was there. Okay. And the returning value like 29.20, you can see. And it is a, what type of value it is? It is?
Float, that is decimal
point.
Float.
Yeah, yeah. Good. Float. Just everyone mute. You can see.
Float type.
Yeah, you can see here void as an input. Void as a input. But here is not, we have not provided any input value, but here the result is generating like 29.20. It is a type of float value. So that result should be stored somewhere. That's why we use one variable, that is the X, and data type is float. So once that result has been stored, once the return value has been stored somewhere, the function is taking a return value as a float, and that function will execute. So these four type of classification you can find in any programming language. No arguments, no return value. With arguments, no return value. With arguments, with return value. No arguments, with return value. So this kind of classification you can find in any programming language, whether you talk about Java or whether you talk about C, C++, .NET, or any programming language. So one note for you, you can see on your screen. The note is, not only definition is important to the functions, along with the function calling is also important. So definition of function, you can see the first top of that column. Okay, this is the definition, and function calling the last row, you can see. After calling that function will execute. And to understand this, we have seen like example like TV remote control. So if I want to switch off TV, I should call like switch off button. If I want to change the channel, I should have used the press to change the channel button. If I wanted to increase or decrease the volume of television, you should use that particular type of button. Means that button is nothing but your function calling. And your channel, your volume is nothing but your functions. So note one is, not only definition is important. Aap jab programming karne lag jaoge, to aap program karte time pe, aap jab ye sari cheeze implement karte jaoge, to aapko dheere dheere ye sari cheeze pata chalengi. Jaise return value aati hai, to isko store kaha karna hai, isko kaise call karna hai, ye sari cheeze aap thoda thoda dheere dheere samajh jaoge. Getting? So note is that, not only definition is important to the functions, we need to call that functions. So not only definition is important to the functions, along with the function calling is also important. Clear? Clear?
Yes,
clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So as a summary, hum isko wapas ek baar recall karte hain, and then program pe switch karte hain. Theek hai? Just concentrate. Here is the definition. What is the function? Function is the set or block of instruction having identity, which is taking input, come up processing the input and producing the output. Identity is nothing but, you can see on your screen, identity is nothing but function name.
Function name.
Yeah, good. Argument list is nothing but, we call it as
input.
Is nothing but, we call it as input.
Output.
Good. So the functions. Functions, good. Mute everyone. The functions start with open and close curly brace. Okay. Integer z equals to x plus y return z. You can see on your screen, these are nothing but the processing logic. Okay. With the help of this example, you can easily understand the functions implementation process. Integer add, integer x, integer y. Here integer is nothing but my return type. Add is my function name. And the integer x, integer y are nothing but my argument list. So integer x, integer y is nothing but my input. Add is my function name, and integer is nothing but my return type. So I'm recalling this definition. What is the function? The function is the set of instructions having identity, which is taking input, come up processing the input and producing the output. That is the functions.
Output.
Yeah. So with the help of this example, we understand very well, I think, function calling. With the help of this concept, we understand the importance of function calling, because each and every function's definition is not important. Definition is only not important. We need to call that function also. Because of that calling function, that function will execute. Okay. So there are four types of arguments. There are four categories of the functions. No arguments, no return value. With arguments, no return value. With arguments, with return value. No arguments, with return value. So these four category you can find in not only C programming language, you can find this four category in any programming language in future once you enter into the second year, third year and final year. Okay. So with the help of these four category implementation, no arguments, no return value, with arguments, no return value. okay, with arguments with return value, no arguments with return value, and this four classification we understood with the help of this example. Okay, one note is important here. Not only definition is important to the functions, along with the function calling is also important. Because of that function calling, that function will execute. All right. So this is all about the function implementation process. Guys, if you are comfortable, can we switch to program or next lecture?
Next lecture, sir.
If you have any question, you can ask me right now. Yes. Nice. Nice. Nice.
Nice.
Nice.
Nice.
Nice. Nice. Nice.
Nice. Nice. Nice. Nice. Nice. Nice. Nice. Nice.
Last evening, one student asked me about one topic, that concept. Within 3 minutes, we will finish it and we will left it. Okay. So the difference between compiler, interpreter, and assembler. Who's that? Who's called me for that? Is there present? The difference between compiler, interpreter, and assembler? Hello? Kisne pucha tha mujhe ye? Wow, kya baat hai?
Nahi hai shayad sir. Absent
hogi sir. So maine usko bola tha ki sare student ko ye samjhana hai mujhe. So hum kal ke lecture mein isko cover karenge. So now. You can concentrate here, guys. The difference between compiler, interpreter, and assembler. इसमें थोड़ा short difference है. ज़्यादा difference, ज़्यादा उसमें deep जाने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Compiler में, interpreter में और assembler में. हमें सिर्फ compiler के साथ काम करना है, interpreter, assembler के साथ नहीं. So आप अगर screen के ऊपर देखोगे तो आपको दिखेगा कि difference between compiler, interpreter, and assembler is that compiler convert whole code. Compiler converts whole high-level language program to machine-level language program. Means, पूरा का पूरा program compiler लेगा और उसको convert करेगा binary language में machine language में. Okay, ठीक है. Interpreter क्या करता है? Interpreter convert करता है high-level language program to machine-level language line by line. दोनों में difference क्या है? Yes, mute everyone. Compiler और interpreter में difference क्या है? Compiler पूरा का पूरा program at a time लेता है और उसको process करता है. बट इंटरप्रेटर जो होता है वो लाइन बाय लाइन एग्जीक्यूट करेगा, एक लाइन दूसरी लाइन तीसरी लाइन, लाइन बाय लाइन उसको कन्वर्ट करेगा मशीन कोड में. और असेंबलर जो है वो असेंबलर कन्वर्ट करता है असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्राम टू मशीन लैंग्वेज. असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्राम आप सीखोगे सेकेंड ईयर में आके, चाहे आप इलेक्ट्रॉनिक से हो, इलेक्ट्रिकल से हो, या कंप्यूटर से, आईटी से, किसी भी ब्रांच से हो. म्यूट गाइस, म्यूट
सर.
Yes. Yes, question. So you can see that the assembler जो है वो एक assembler, assembly programming language होती है, जिसे assembly programming language कहा जाता है.
सर वो ALU वाली ना, वो जो 12th में थी, वो मूव ए टू बी.
तो वो अलग है, असेंबलर अलग है. वो क्या करता है, वो असेंबली लैंग्वेज को मशीन लैंग्वेज में कन्वर्ट करता है. सो यहाँ पे आप कंपेयर करना है कंपाइलर इंटरप्रेटर को, तो एक बात ध्यान में रखनी है आप लोगों को. कंपाइलर पूरा का पूरा प्रोग्राम एज ए इनपुट लेता है और उसको प्रोसेस करता है मशीन लैंग्वेज में. बट इंटरप्रेटर जो है वो लाइन बाय लाइन लेता है प्रोग्राम को और वो लाइन बाय लाइन उसको कन्वर्ट करता है मशीन लैंग्वेज में. मशीन लैंग्वेज इज नथिंग बट योर बाइनरी लैंग्वेज और कंप्यूटर अंडरस्टैंडेबल लैंग्वेज. और जो असेंबलर है वो असेंबलर जो है वो प्रोग्राम को असेंबली लैंग्वेज को मशीन लैंग्वेज में कन्वर्ट करता है. असेंबली लैंग्वेज वो एक अलग लैंग्वेज है, वो माइक्रोप्रोसेसर या चिप के ऊपर प्रोग्रामिंग करने के लिए यूज होता है.
सिंबॉलिक लैंग्वेज.
या ओके, सो दिस वन क्वेश्चन, सो ये सबके लिए भी इंपॉर्टेंट था, सो मैंने इसको लेक्चर में ही कवर किया. हैव यू एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क मी?
नो सर.